Let's go straight over to our studio audience this afternoon and see what they felt. How do you feel then that, right from a child, that you've been kind of pushed into a certain mould to become a certain type of person, so that when you get to a certain age, girls begin wearing makeup and boys begin wearing, you know, DMs or splashing on Brut or whatever. Right, you want to talk on that?
Yes,
okay.
I feel very good because I've been brought up to think that girls should, you know, stay at home, look after the kids, and boys should go out and have all the fun, play rough games. And I've got two brothers, and I've always been separated. I can't play with them. When I was little, that was. My mum always used to tell me off that, you know, that's boys' games, you know, don't play football, don't climb trees, you know. And I feel very bad about that. I think children should be brought up equal, you know, and that parents shouldn't say, oh, let boys play with soldiers and tanks and let girls play with dolls, because that's what starts off a lot of trouble when they grow older.
But, I mean, when you were a child, did you want to play with tanks and
Yes,
soldiers?
I did.
But was that just because you weren't allowed to?
No. I think that when you're young, you don't really know what girls are supposed to do, you know, it's just what your parents teach you.
Yeah.
So, you know, you do anything, it just depends on your nature. Like, some boys are quiet and they like to play with dolls. I mean, it's just up to the person.
You laugh at that. Why do you laugh at that? Do you think it's unnatural
it's
for
odd.
Boys? Why? Why do you think it's odd for boys to play with dolls?
It's not. We've got action men to play with. They dress them up in their army uniforms. Just dress them up in different things.
Yeah.
Girls
like
to make up dolls. Boys like to throw stones at them.
Yes, that's very good. But in the sense that an action man is no different from a Cindy doll. So how do you think this goes on to school then? That when you go through school, that you're conditioned to do certain things. You want to speak?
When you go through school, if a girl does metalwork, it looks different. The teachers don't like it. Well, when I went to school, some boys did cooking and no one did needlework. They wouldn't, you know, they just sat in the corner, they wouldn't do it. I wouldn't do it, I thought it was stupid.
Yeah, why would you feel stupid doing needlework?
I just hated it, I thought, I can't say it saved my life. I could cook, I was a good cook, I was better than most girls. I enjoyed cooking. I hated sewing. I thought that was woman's work.
One of our studio guests, I can see, makes one point. And I should say that we've got four people in the studio this afternoon. An airline pilot, managing director of a company, a nurse, and a housekeeper. It's actually Terry Doyle that wants to make the first point. Now, I've said you were a housekeeper then, didn't I? How would you describe yourself and what's your point?
Talking about needle, I do my own needlework. I have no one else to do it for me, but I don't feel any the less masculine for doing it.
Yeah.
I do the washing, all the things that a mother would do, but I still have a daytime job. I still go to work.
Yeah.
So I don't feel anything.
And you have a daughter which you look after as
Yes, yeah, a 7-year-old daughter.
Yeah.
And it's fine.
Yeah.
There's no difficulty at all.
But wouldn't you have appreciated now, because of your present situation, if when you were at school, you'd have had needlework lessons?
No, I wouldn't. No.
Why not?
I don't know, really. I suppose if all the other guys had done it, I would have fallen in line.
Yeah, but I mean, you would have actually used it. It would have actually come into use now.
It would,
wouldn't it?
Yes.
I mean, do
you
get the needle in your finger a lot?
Sometimes.
The problem is with this sort of discussion is that I know that we're brought up to believe that girls stay at home, boys go out to work and all the rest of it, and you're indoctrinated at home and through the media and perhaps to school to a certain extent, though I don't think it really is now, to be quite honest. It's still, you're quite free, certainly when you get to our age, to really do what you want to do. I mean, if girls really didn't want to do that, they are in a position to say no and just chuck it all in and go their own way.
Let's go to some of the people who have actually broken out of some of these roles. Judith Chisholm, perhaps you could say something about the problems you had in becoming an airline pilot.
Yeah, absolutely. In fact, I think what you're just saying is entirely wrong. A woman can't just do what she wants to. On a fairly simple and superficial level, a woman cannot just simply become an airline pilot. To become an airline pilot requires a lot of expensive training. If you're a man, you can join the military, you can be a fighter pilot and have a lot of fun blowing people up. Or you can be sponsored by an airline. As a woman, you have to sponsor yourself, and this costs anything upwards of £20,000, and most school leavers don't have this amount of money. At school, women are taught, or certainly when I was at school, it was considered that women had to be school teachers or nurses or that sort of thing. For example, I spent, do you know, when I was 16 years old, I spent every Thursday morning, the whole of Thursday morning, learning how to cook stuff like semolina pudding. Now, this is all very well, but that was 1/10 of my working life as a 16-year-old. Now, frankly, I think that anybody, we're talking about cooking and needlework, anybody can cook. I get very irritated with men that say they can't boil an egg or sew a button on their shirts, equally with women that say they can't change a wheel on a car. All this is simple stuff. If you've got any average intelligence, you can do this, and it shouldn't be taught in schools.
Yes, absolutely. What about some of the other people? Val Agut. Now, you're a managing director of sorts. What do you actually managing direct?
Well, I'm a managing director of a law school, but I suppose by trade, as it were, I'm a solicitor. I'd certainly agree with what Judith has said in that a lot of the problems in qualifying and in becoming something that isn't recognised initially as a female role is the prejudice you get from parents and teachers. I mean, my headmistress definitely thought that being a lawyer was definitely a non-feminine thing to do. And she said, you really ought to go and be a school teacher because that's an acceptable female role, whereas being a lawyer isn't an acceptable role.
Yeah.
If I can for a minute. As a woman as well, you have to get anywhere. I think boys are generally pushed a little bit harder at school because they have to support, it's considered they have to support a family. As a woman, you're not pushed as much, so you have to be pushy and determined, and that's considered unfeminine. So you
right.
Hassled from both ends.
OK, we've got a nurse as one of our guests this afternoon. Tony Travis. Got it. Now, why did you decide to go into nursing, and what are the problems you've come up against in that?
I decided to go into nursing because when I left college, I could see myself heading for a job which meant me sitting behind a desk, pushing a pen, working Monday to Friday, 9 to 5, and to me, that wasn't the job for me. And I looked around and I thought, well, I like to work with people. And nursing seemed the one opportunity to go in and work with people and a job that I enjoyed. And it is a job where you don't work routine hours. Okay, you don't have much of a social life, but then again, it's a job where if you don't want routine, it's a good one to go into.
How do your friends and people that you say meet at parties and things react to the fact that you're a nurse?
Well, you get two responses. The first one is, oh, you're a nurse, a male nurse. What does a male nurse do? You say it does exactly the same as what a female does. And then the second one is a sort of a stand back and a barrier comes down between you. You know, I think, well, a male doing a nursing job doesn't seem right.
What about the problems with things like nursing on an all-female ward or nursing on a mixed ward? I mean, how do you feel that you're actually treated within the hospital system? Is it exactly the same as being a female nurse?
Well, at the hospital I'm at, there's two sides. On one side, there's mixed wards, which have equal amounts of females and males, and you work on that one. But on the surgical side, there's a male ward and a female ward. And you end up working on just the male ward as a male nurse. And it seems strange, because one week you might be working with female patients, and next week you're not allowed near them.
Yeah. How do people feel about this? Lots of things there that you might want to come back on. Let's see the hands and let's see where we're going to go. OK, right there in the blue first. That's you, yeah.
Yeah. I was just like to say that I think it's very hard for a woman or a man to sort of step out of their normal role and say, well, I, as a man, want to be a nurse and I, as a woman, want to be an airline pilot, because they have to sort of neglect all they've been taught before.
That's right, in the middle.
From when you're children, right, that your parents try and tell you you've got to do this, you've got to play with dolls. Then at school, it's happened to me, I wanted to go into engineering. They said, no, you've got to do this instead.
But why didn't you, if you wanted to do it, why didn't you do it?
I tried. Don't you understand?
That means you never made...
Yeah, I tried, okay? I really tried. I give my school one thing, that you have to do a science, okay? But when I wanted to do the science that I wanted to do, they made me do something else.
One thing was school. School is a thing you've got to fight, because when you're in school, if a guy wants to do cooking, you've got your mate saying, look, mate, don't do it. And then you think to yourself, oh, look, they're all against me. And if you want to fight, you're going to do it, because I did cooking
in school. Yeah, well, that's what I'm trying to do.
You've got to fight for yourself, innit? You don't fight for nobody else, you fight for yourself.
Can we come to Judith and Val and ask you how you feel? Like, the question that's come up here is whether people can actually fight the system, fight the way things have always been. Do you think, first, Val, do you feel that it really can work, that people really can go against the grain, which has been in this country for goodness
knows how many years. Yeah, I feel this very strongly, because I think the more people that do go against the grain, the more it becomes an accepted norm. I mean, I did law, and immediately after me, five people in the year behind me did law. And once somebody starts, you've got, it's much easier for the people coming behind. But if nobody actually takes the step to do it, then we'll all be secretaries.
So then do you think that organisations like Women's Lib are a good thing?
No.
In...
I think...
Come on then, well, answer for
I
it.
I think Judith disagrees with me on this, but...
Well, we'll get over
I think that Women's Lib has probably done more to destroy female equality. And I think here we have to differentiate between Women's Lib and equality of opportunity, which are two totally different things.
May I ask you a rather personal question? Have you, to get to where you are now, used the fact that you are a woman? You've used your natural feminine charm to get up in the company that you're in?
Well, obviously it helps. I mean, everybody uses every advantage they've got. I mean, if you're a stunningly attractive man and you can get somewhere by chatting up whoever you've got to chat up on in the company or wherever you want to go, you use it. And I think the same would go whether you're male or female. If you've got a particular attribute...
Judith, what do you think about this question?
I think that it's an unfair world, and if you've got anything, you use it. As far as I'm concerned...
you've got it and you use it.
Well, no, being a woman... I would. If I thought it was going to help, believe me, I would.
Has it helped you in your career?
No point in not fighting dirty as a woman. No point at all.
No point in not fighting dirty as a woman.
The odds are against you. You have to use everything you've got. In my particular field, I don't think I've come across many situations in which being a woman would have helped, but if it would, then I'd use it, of course.
Yeah. Okay,
the guys who fall for that kind of are fools. Because girls, women use every trick in the book to get what they want. And it's never. They know they can do it.
You're saying, really, in effect, it's a bit of a battle.
Yeah,
and the only trouble
is, man can't do that.
Right, well, that's it. I'm afraid there is no more time for this debate this afternoon. It seems to me, from what we've been saying this afternoon, that if you want to be what you want to be, you've got to fight for it, and it really depends upon the amount of fight you've got.